And so I'm going to call this my 2.5 minute review of Destiny Rise of Iron. Now, the review hasn't started yet, but if you watch the show, you know I am a Destiny fan. That is a game I love playing. I love getting online with my friends and grinding some stuff out and playing it. It's a great time. And really, anytime they would release just a little bit of new content, whether it be an expansion or just a DLC, I always loved it because it's like, yeah, something a little bit new to do. So keep that in mind as the review goes forward. So Destiny Rise of Iron had dropped last week, and it was really just an expansion. They gave you a couple new things to add on, a new social space. They added kind of a new patrol area and kind of a new enemy to fight. So, you know, they did give us new stuff, but a lot of it felt reskinned. So I'm not going to get into the whole usual, like, how's the gameplay, how are the graphics, you know, stuff like that, because, you know, I've done those reviews before. I want to say I reviewed the original Destiny a long time ago. I don't know. It's somewhere up on our channel. I know it is. Yeah, I want to say we were doing the show by the time I did the first Destiny.
Reviews of Destiny, you did probably updates of Destiny later on. We've talked about Destiny a lot.
Yes. So I am a big fan of Destiny. That being said, I am pretty disappointed with this new DLC. Now, the DLC, they weren't touting it to be huge, but they were touting it to be an expansion. And it's not big enough in my mind to be considered an expansion. It's really right there along the lines of a DLC. The story mission you get literally spans about 5 missions, takes you all of about 1.5 hours to beat, and then it's all grind from there. Now, the raid did come out last weekend. I did not jump into the raid quite yet because I was not high enough level. And don't get me wrong, my opinion can change drastically if the raid is amazing. Because if the raid is amazing, that gives you what you want. That is giving you that social structure where you have to play with your friends, play with your teammates, and, you know, just go have a good time. And that's really what I love about Destiny. But Destiny, as it is, they made it. And now I'm going to start jumping into some technical Destiny terms, and hopefully you played Destiny, you know what I'm talking about. But they made it so that you had to be a level 370 light level. That's pretty much your power level to want to do the raid. That's the recommended light level. Well, right now I'm at 360. I had the game for a whole week, and they start you out at 335 when you jump into the expansion because that was the highest light level you could have had from last year. And so I was 335 with a character, and I was jumping in. I was doing everything I was supposed to, beat the story. Gives you garbage, doesn't really level you up. And then come to find out, like, you're out of missions, no way to level up your character anymore. How do I do it? And they have these things called strikes. They're kind of mini raids almost, but 10-15 minute long missions that you can do with big bosses at the end. And they say you just got to jump in there, grind it out, you'll get some good gear from it. Well, the grind is insane. So I had to work on Saturday on the phones for my company where I kind of answer the phones. And so I was on the phones from 10 until 9 on Saturday. So fun day for me, but it is what it is. But from 10 until 3, I was playing Destiny while I was answering the phones because, you know, they wasn't getting constant calls. It's a Saturday. It was a little bit slower. So I was playing. I literally played from 10 until 3 and only leveled my character up 5 light levels. Do you know how frustrating that is? I should have been max character. If the story's only going to take me 1.5 hours to beat, I shouldn't have to take 35 hours to reach max level to just join the raid. Max level is actually 385, and then it'll be 400 after the hard raid comes out. But I couldn't even get to the level where they recommend that you can play in the raid.
Yeah, that's and that's bad. Very frustrating. Balance problems.
Yeah, so I love Destiny, and I am playing it a lot more because I got new content. But you didn't give me much, and the stuff you did give me, you just put it behind a wall of grind. Super grind. Now, I love the grind, but you have to feel like you're getting a little bit more of a reward out of the grind. I am the guy here. I maxed out all the sphere levels for Final Fantasy X. Now, again, you hopefully know what I'm talking about when I say that, but that is a task. That is something you have to grind to do. For all my characters, like, that's making everybody level 99, like the highest level you can make. I did that. I am happy to do that in games as long as you feel the progression. But when you play for 6 hours and you don't feel the progression, it hurts. 5 hours, sorry, 5 hours. It hurts. Well, that's not even to mention the next 4 hours I played later that night with another one of my buddies. So that's neither here nor there. So I'm kind of disappointed with the expansion. They didn't give us as much as they gave us even in The Taken King. And it doesn't feel like we're going forward. And it almost feels like they were just like, hey, we're just going to kind of reskin a bunch of things, throw them out at you, which is all they did for this expansion. There's no real new areas. It's all just reskinned characters, pretty much. Throw them out at you. Say, here, play for 50 hours if you want to hit max level, and then there's your game. Now, they didn't charge full retail price. It was only $30, so it's not like they were ripping anybody off. But, you know, it's supposed to hold me over for Destiny 2, and it's not going to. I'm probably going to be done with it by October. And that's with me starting to raid. And I will get my raid group back together, which is nice, because I've already gotten messages from a couple of them from on my PlayStation thing, like, get ready, we're going to start raiding again, which is a lot of fun. And if you've ever played a game like that where you do have a group of guys or guys and girls, I don't mean to be sexist, there's plenty of girls playing this game, there's nothing better, because it's like you're hanging out with your buddies every time you jump into one of those, and you can joke, you can laugh, you can have a really good time. And I'm really looking forward to that. But there comes a certain point where everybody gets bored doing the same thing over and over. And that point is going to come real soon. So if I'm going to rate it, I would give it a 2 out of 5.
Wow.
For Destiny Rise of Iron.
Wow,
it's not cool. That the content they do give us is bad. It's great content that they give us, but they just don't give us enough. Now, again, I'm going to preface that by saying I haven't jumped into the raid yet. But even if the raid is the best raid that I've ever played in Destiny, that's only going to raise it just a hair. Because, again, it's just not enough.
How much
this is a game I'm
to again?
$30. 30.
Yeah, that.
So, like I said, I'm not hating on the price. The price wasn't that bad, but Taken King was $40, and it feels like they gave me double the amount of stuff. So I'd rather pay an extra $10 and get double the amount of stuff. So who knows? And now Destiny, Bungie's out there saying, "Oh, we're going to plan some events. We're doing more things." But they said that last year. They said, "We're not going to give you DLCs this year because we're going to plan events." Well, they did 3, maybe 4 events over the whole year, and it wasn't enough. So here's hoping for something a little bit more out of this. And maybe there's something I haven't quite gotten to that just you can't get to quite yet because they haven't unlocked it. And they did do that in year with the Taken King. They unlocked certain things as the weeks went on to expand on the game. And maybe they're going to do that, but I haven't heard that they're going to do that. I heard a lot about that with Taken King. So, yeah, I mean, for a game that I love and that I will continue playing, I'm very disappointed in you, Bungie. I mean, just not enough. I mean, you really, if you wanted to do this, you should have just said, here's another DLC, like the other ones, not a full expansion. Here's another DLC, and sorry, you're going to have to wait until next year to get Destiny 2. And I would have been like, well, you know what? Focus your energies on Destiny 2. I'll be back then. But they didn't do that.
Nope.
Well, and here's one thing, though. I was worried that I wouldn't have enough time to play Skyrim when it came out. I'll have plenty of time to play the remastered version of that when that comes out. And I don't want to. That's the problem. Like, I love Skyrim. That game, I probably put more time into Skyrim than any other game. And that's pretty much why I don't want to jump back into it. Because having a life is sometimes nice. Going out, sometimes cool. But I sacrifice for you.
With your brother sometimes. That's cool.
That's never cool.
You've never done it. That's why it's not cool.
All right. Fair enough. Fair enough. But you know that doesn't stop me from rating things here, at least on this show. Because like I said, I didn't even play the raid. And I gave it a 2. So, but yeah, hit us up. Let us know what you think. Am I being too harsh on Destiny Rise of Iron? Or do you think I'm spot on? Hit me up. Let me know. Comments down below, of course. @WorstMyFace on Twitter. Google Plus on Facebook. Always good ways to get a hold of us.